Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. In this video, we're going to look at the single engine ILS approach. Using the Fenix A320 today inside Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024, and we have currently have the simulator paused, shortly intercepting the ILS to runway 27 at Liverpool Echo Golf Golf Papa. Now, the single engine ILS approach, if you were doing this as part of your type rating or a 6-monthly proficiency check, well, you'd have to fly this approach manually. So you would take the autopilot out and the auto thrust system and fly the aircraft down using our side stick. That is how I'm going to fly the approach today. So we're going to intercept the ILS and I'm going to take the autopilot out and then the auto thrust system and fly the aircraft in. Airbus do, however, recommend the use of maximum automation where possible to reduce pilot workload. So if this scenario was to happen out flying on the line, we'd more than likely fly this using the automation down unless there were further failures, which meant that the automation was unavailable, which is why we have to have the skills practiced and tested in order to take over if we need to. So we've got the number one left-hand engine failed today. One thing to be aware of is if we were to take manual control, take the autopilot out, the pilot flying becomes responsible for the rudder trim. At the moment, down here, it's a rudder trim. This is something we don't use very often, but in a single engine scenario, this is where it comes in generally. So the system's currently auto trimming to the right, 2.9 units of rudder trim. And if we were to take the autopilot out, we'll be responsible for maintaining that trim and ensuring the lower beta target stays in line with the upper triangle there. So you've got them nicely balanced on the primary flight display. To do that, we need to input rudder. So we need to be aware of which rudder input to use. We don't want to be pushing on the wrong pedal because that's going to destabilize the aircraft. But there's a couple of ways of remembering this. We've got the number one left-hand engine dead. So you can say dead engine, dead leg. So left engine's dead, left leg's dead. So don't use the left leg. Or working engine, working leg. So engine 2 is working on the right leg is working, so we're going to push on the right rudder pedal to put our trim input in if we need to. So that's a way of remembering that. Also, if we're taking manual control in this situation with a single engine in a clean or flaps 1 config, so we're flaps 1 config now, there's a bit of a rule of thumb to remember in terms of, you know, setting the aircraft up and getting coordinated for this approach. And that is the 3.7s. Which are 7 units of rudder trim, 70% N1, so this is our thrust setting up here, currently 65.3, and a 700 foot descent rate, which is indicated on the primary flight display. So they're the 3.7s. That's obviously a guide, and those will need to be tweaked, but in terms of setting yourself up initially, that's a great starting point to work from. So remember the 3.7s. Something else to be aware of is pilots sometimes forget to match the thrust setting to that 70%, so you want to move the blue ball down to the 70% target, just there, before deselecting the auto thrust. And we use these red switches here on the throttles for that. I do have a separate video on that to show you how that all works on the approach if you want to take manual control of thrust. Failure to do so would result in the thrust increasing to the 87.2%, which would destabilise your approach. It's really important that we remember to bring that thrust down before we disconnect the auto thrust system. So I'm going to unpause the sim now and intercept the ILS for runway 27 at Liverpool, and I will subsequently disconnect the autopilot and then the auto thrust system and fly the aircraft in. Cat 3 single, autopilot 1 and 2, glide slope blue, lock blue. Lock star, GS star. Flaps 2, speed checks, flaps 2. And gear down. Flaps 3, speed checks, flaps 3. autopilot's coming out. Pulling the throttle back now to about 70%. Also thrust disconnected. Flaps full, speed checks, flaps full. Landing checklist, go around altitude 2000 blue. ECAM MO landing, no blue. Landing checklist complete. Small changes on thrust, should be no more than 10% either way, any time. Wind right up nose. Continue.
100.
So that's the single engine ILS flow manually. Obviously you can leave the automation in and perform an auto land as long as your winds are in limit, and that is allowed by your specific company standard operating procedures. If you have any questions on that, please drop them in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.